Fine-tuning open source models can be a daunting and expensive task, especially when it comes to models like MPT-7B. According to its documentation, training this model requires at least 8 A100 GPUs, which can amount to around $20 to $25 per hour. However, there is a secret trick that enables you to train open source models using a single GPU. This technique can significantly reduce the training time and costs involved without sacrificing much performance. Sounds awesome, right? Yes, but there are some trade-offs. So in this video, I will show you how you can fine-tune any open source model with ease and efficiency using this one secret trick so you can achieve the best possible results for your specific use case. Let's get started. MPT-7B is an open source model that's been making waves in the AI community. It's been trained on an immense volume of data featuring 1 million tokens. This model performs at par with Llama on various benchmarks and can even process extremely long inputs up to 65k tokens, twice the capability of GPT-4. But what makes MPT-7B truly stand out from the rest is that it's fully commercially available. Yes, this means that you can deploy and use this model in your own application without worrying about Mark Zuckerberg knocking on your door with a lawsuit. Besides, it is fully compatible with the Hugging Face ecosystem, which makes it super convenient to use. But to understand the fine-tuning process, we first need to differentiate between fine-tuning and pre-training. Firstly, pre-training involves training a model on a broad dataset to capture as much information about the underlying structure as possible. Think of it as learning music theory before learning how to play the guitar. This foundational skill you've acquired through pre-training with music theory can greatly speed up your guitar learning process. On the other hand, during the fine-tuning phase, the model is trained further on a smaller and more specific dataset. For instance, the new instruction models were fine-tuned to follow instructions. Therefore, when you ask them a question, they learn to provide a response instead of simply continuing the text like the older versions. This is why you only need around 100 examples to make the latest instruct models classify your emails accurately, when if you tried to fine-tune a base model, it would have taken you thousands of examples or even more. If you'd like another tutorial on fine-tuning, let me know in the comments. Now, let's get back to the secret trick. The secret to fine-tuning large language models on a single GPU lies in freezing the weights. Instead of training all layers of a machine learning model, you can simply train only the last one or a last few. Layers are essentially building blocks of the model. Each layer processes input data, performs certain computations on it, and passes the results to the next layer. Typically, the first layers of the model learn more general information, such as sentence structures or context, while the last layers learn more specific information, such as the actual meanings of the words. In most of the use cases, we don't need to retrain the model on sentence structures since they don't differ significantly for most language tasks. Instead, we can freeze these weights and only update the last few layers, saving computational resources without compromising much performance or accuracy. So now, to better understand this concept, let's walk through a notebook I've created for fine-tuning MPT-7B Instruct on Google Colab. To start, install the required packages and import them into your notebook. Note that a pro subscription is required to run this notebook if you're fine-tuning MPT-7B. You can also find a smaller model and adapt this notebook instead. After you imported the packages, copy the required code to run the MPT-7B Instruct model. Next, define a generate function. This function will be used to test the model. For example, if you input hello, the model should respond with hi. This indicates that the code is working as expected. After that, load the dataset for fine-tuning. For this task, we will use a dataset called AG News from Hugging Face. This dataset features a variety of news articles divided into four categories. Now, split this dataset into training and validation segments. While doing so, ensure that the labels are evenly distributed across all categories. This is extremely important for classification tasks because if, for example, your training dataset only contains sports articles, the model would learn to predict this label exclusively, resulting in biased responses. Now, create train and test data loaders for your dataset using PyTorch. Once your data loaders are set up, test an example from the dataset to see the model's response. You may notice that the model may add redundant text, such as the paragraph above can be classified and so on. It may also output multiple labels, which is not ideal in a production environment. Therefore, fine-tuning the model is crucial for this task. Now comes the secret piece of code. Instead of fine-tuning all layers, we'll simply fine-tune the last one, which is layer 31. To achieve this, setParam requires grad to false for all parameters in all other layers. Next, define your training parameters and set up your trainer from Hugging Face with your data and the model. You are now ready to start training. For this exercise, the number of epochs is set to 50. Depending on your dataset's complexity and size, you may need to adjust these parameters. However, even after 50 iterations, you should notice a substantial improvement. Using the same example we tried before, the fine-tuned model now outputs just one word, business, which is exactly what we want. You can find the complete code for this notebook in the description. If you have a more challenging project that you need help with, feel free to reach out to me. I will also be answering all the questions in the comments. In conclusion, fine-tuning is like supercharging your model for your specific task, and freezing can help you achieve optimal results much faster. Moreover, you can use this technique with any model, not just language models. But as I mentioned earlier, there are some trade-offs involved. For instance, freezing only the last layer might work well for classification tasks. However, since only the last layer is trained, the model might not be able to pick up on more complex patterns required for more complex use cases like text generation. Nevertheless, you can always try to unfreeze more layers if the performance is not good enough. So definitely experiment with this trick, because in the future videos we will dive even deeper into fine-tuning and try newer methods like Clora. And if you don't want to miss out, don't forget to subscribe.